Hi friends, let's study transferable credits part 2. If a credit is transferred to more than one second bene and rejection means rejection of an amendment by one or more second bene does not invalidate the acceptance by other second bene with respect to which the transferred credit will be amended accordingly. You can read this, I'll explain it to you. This is the main LC, this is the first bene, and these are the second beneficiaries. This first bene transfers this main LC to three suppliers, 1, 2, 3. Now there is an amendment received in this main LC and he also transfers this amendment to the three suppliers. Now if supplier 1 rejects this amendment, it doesn't mean that supplier 2 and 3 have also rejected this amendment and this amendment stands invalidated. It only means supplier 1 has rejected and remaining 2 have accepted. It means the LC is amended for these two suppliers and the LC is unamended for this supplier. This clause means this much only. Now let's see what can be changed and what cannot be changed in the transferred LC from the main LC, means difference between the transferred and the main LC. Here you can read this, but I'll tell you one trick. It's just 2 money and 3 dates, means amount of the credit can be changed to the second bene, to the third bene, second bene basically. Unit price can be changed, expiry date, period of presentation and latest shipment date. All these five things will be reduced. Nothing would be increased because for these two parts, the first bene's commission is there. And these three parts, he needs to get some time to change his invoices and present it to the main applicant. That's why these are always reduced. The percentage for which insurance cover must be affected may be increased to provide the amount of cover stipulated in UCP 600. Remember, this part is very important to understand. I'll explain it. In the first LC, the unit price is $100 and there is only one unit to be shipped. So as per the UCP, the insurance cover should be 110%, so it should be $110. Now this LC is transferred to the second applicant. Now in this case we will consider only one supplier is there, there are no 2 and 3. So this middleman will subtract his commission from this price and give the unit price of $80 to this second supplier. Now this guy, if he does again the 110%, then the insurance would be $88. But in the main LC, the insurance required is 110. So what he must do is bring this insurance amount to 110 as required in the main LC. So how much percent is the insurance then? 137.5%. Whereas in the main LC, it's only 110%. Remember this point. Insurance in the second LC needs to be brought to the amount in the first LC, not the percentage, to the amount in the first LC. Okay? If generally the name of the first bene in the main LC is replaced as applicant in the second credit, in the second LC, but if the main LC requires specifically that the name of the applicant, original applicant, should be reflected in the LC, it means in the applicant field in the second LC, the name of the first LC's applicant should be reflected in the second LC also. Remember this part. The name of the applicant should be reflected in the second LC also, if required by the LC. So this was it regarding transferable credit part 2. We'll study the remaining parts, remaining theory in transferable credits 3 video. So keep studying, keep watching these videos. You can download this app from Play Store so as to get these educational videos, question banks, notes, tests and new job openings. Keep studying, keep watching.